politics, and also we discussed what is election. What do you mean by election, Anjida?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, election.
Election means it's a process through which people can choose their representatives.
People can choose their representatives. It's a process in which the people can choose their representatives. Representatives. Vishnupriya.
Yes, ma'am. Choose yes. Their representatives at regular intervals and change them if they wish to.
Clear, dear? Anjida? That means election is a process in which we can choose the representatives at a regular interval. That is important. Only then election have a importance there, right? So we can choose the elected representatives at a particular interval. It is called as election. Then in an election, okay Prajod, in an election the voters have many choices. Rose, can you say the major choices of the voters in an election process?
They can choose who will make the laws for them.
Okay, they can choose who make the laws for them.
They can choose who will form the government and take major decisions.
Yes.
They can choose the party whose policies will guide the government and lawmaking.
Okay, right. So that point we discussed in the last class, right? And today we are going to discuss what make an election democratic. Next topic is what make an election democratic. So why do we need election? The next is what make an election democratic. In the first chapter we discussed about
ear buds, marcalator, buds.
Please mute your audios. Okay, what make an election democratic? The election can be conducted in many ways. Nowadays, I think you are familiar with South Korea. Who is ruling South Korea now?
Kim Jong-un.
Louder. No need for exact name. What is his name?
Kim Jong-un.
Kim? Louder.
Ma'am, that correct. Is North Korea.
North Korea. Then where?
Kim Jong-un.
Ah. Yes. Is he a democratic ruler?
No.
No. Why?
He's a military.
That means the old power is vested to him, right? That means the election can be held in any ways. No need for conducting China. They are also conducting election. But can we say it's a democratic way of conducting election?
No.
No. Then what is the difference between conducting election in a democratic country and a non-democratic country? That points we discussed in the last chapter, first chapter. The politics, first chapter we discussed about so many points, what make an election democratic. So here also we are discussing the same points, what make an election democratic. The first one is, everyone should be able to choose their representatives. What does it mean? Everyone should be able to choose their representatives. That means in a democratic form of government, or in a, if an election must be democratic, if every people get a chance to choose their representatives, that everyone should have one vote and every vote have equal value. You remember any country we studied as an example? Where value of vote is different?
Fiji.
Fiji, very good. So first one is, everyone should be able to choose their representatives. How everyone can choose their representatives? Through vote, right? How we are choosing our representatives? Through vote. So if an election is democratic, only if the people can choose their representatives and each people vote have the same value. Suppose in India, the election is there and we are electing our representatives through voting. But the vote value of vote is different. If a rich person or an educated person, their vote have more value than an uneducated or a poor person. Can we call such country as a democratic country?
No.
No. Is the election procedure there is in a democratic way? Definitely no. Why? Because in a democratic form of government, an election or the election process is democratic only if the people can choose their representatives. How people are choosing their representatives?
By
how
vote.
Choosing our representatives? Through vote. Vote, and everyone should have the right to vote, and also every vote should have equal value. So what make an election democratic? The first point is, everyone should be able to choose their representatives. How people are choosing their representatives? Through vote. Then, in the case of vote, every people equal value for all the votes, and every person have how many vote?
One vote.
One vote, one value. The vote should be based on the principle of one vote, one value. One vote, one value. That's the first point. What make an election democratic? These points we discuss in the first chapter. The same points in a different way. In the first chapter, we studied one person, one vote, one value. Here, another term they are using, that is, everyone should be able to choose their representatives through voting. And vote means each person have one vote and all vote have the same value. Clear, children? Is it clear?
Yes, ma'am.
First point. Then the second one is, parties and candidates should be free to contest election. That means the people or the parties, different parties can participate in the election process. There should be something to choose from. Parties and candidates should be free to contest election and should offer some real choice to the voters. Why I am reading the points in the textbook is, you are reading from the textbook, right? So if any doubt is there, you can ask. That's why. Again, reading the same points from the textbook. The second one is, this is a shortcut points. Only the gist is in the PPT. Second one is, the parties and candidates should be free to contest election. Can you say any country where the parties and candidates are not free to contest election?
North Korea.
Louder. We studied a country where parties and candidates are not free to participate in the election. Which country?
China.
Ah, very good. It's in China and Mexico. You remember the two examples? So the parties and candidates should be free to contest election. That means we studied an example of a non-democratic country where China. In China, is the election process is a democratic one? Is it a democratic election in China? Why all of your videos are again off? Hadi? Hadi?
Yes, ma'am.
Is election in China is democratic one?
No.
Why?
They are not free to candidates.
How many parties are there?
One.
The country is dominated by one party. What is the name of that party?
Communist.
Which country? Chinese?
Communist
party. And they are, that is a leading party in China. And if you want to become a, if you want to participate, if you want to become a candidate in the election, you need the approval of the Communist Party or any of its allied party. Only then you can become the candidate in the election. Can we say in such countries the election process is a democratic one?
No.
No. But in the case of India, is any restriction like that is here?
No.
So if no. any party, you are from any party, you can become a candidate in the election. But some procedures are there that is laid down in the constitution. If you are qualified, all that things, you can become a candidate in the election process. That's the second one. That is, the parties and candidates should be free to contest election. If you are from any party, or you are from a candidate of any party, if you are free to contest election, we can call in such a country the election is contesting as a democratic way. So the second point is, there should be something to choose from, and the parties and candidates should be free to contest election and should offer some real choice to the voters. That means the parties and candidates should be free to contest election. Only then the people get a choice to choose the person whom we want to select, who want to rule us. If only one party is there, the people have no choice. From the same party itself, only one candidate is there also, the people have no choice. For the last 20 years, the same candidate is there. Or from the last 20 years, only one party is there from a particular place. The people have no more choices. So the first point is, everyone should be able to choose their representatives. Second point, the parties and candidates should be free to contest election. Third one, election must be held regularly after a certain interval. That is very important. The people need a choice. A choice should be offered to them after a particular interval. After a regular interval, we must offer a choice to the people to select their representatives. So the election must conduct at regular intervals. In India, what is the interval period for contesting the election?
5 years.
5 years. For a 5 years, we are selecting a representative for a maximum 5 years. Only an exception is to Rajya Sabha. There only 6 years. Rest all, if you are, if it is to the state legislative assembly or to the Lok Sabha or to the local bodies, they are elected for a time period of 5 years. Only then people will get a chance to select a leader. Only then the people will get a chance. We must give some offers to the people. If there is no interval period, we cannot say that the country election process is in democratic. So the third point is, the parties and candidates should be free to contest election. Sorry, the election must be held at regularly after a certain intervals. So the first point is, everyone should be able to choose their representatives. Second one, the parties and candidates should be free to contest election. Third point, election must be held regularly after a certain interval. Clear, children? Any doubt to anyone? Anyone? These three points, any point want to explain again? Yes or no, you can say.
No, ma'am.
Melvin, any point want to explain, dear?
I have a
network
problem. I didn't hear any points.
Louder.
I didn't hear any points. I had a network problem.
Now only when I called you, only you remember that?
No, I have a network.
Okay. Now only, you know, you joined at the earlier.
No, I was there in the class, but network.
Arjun, any power failure there?
No.
Then the next point. So the first point is everyone should be able to choose their representatives. That means it is based on the principle of voting, the universal adult franchise. All the people have must need the right to vote, and each vote have one value. Second one, the parties and candidates should be free to contest election. The people, third point is the election must be held at regularly after a certain interval. The fourth point is a candidate preferred by the people should get elected. The candidate preferred by the people should get elected. That is also important. See, the people's preference must have importance. We are electing the candidate on the principle of vote, and that candidate should be declared as the elected one. Fourth one, the candidate preferred by the people should get elected. That means don't use any dirty tricks at the time of election. Last point is, election should be conducted in a free and fair manner. That is very important. Where people can only, if the election is not conducting in a free and fair manner, we cannot say that the election in that country is held at a democratic way. So the election should be conducted in a free and fair manner. So what make an election democratic? The five points we discussed, what make an election democratic? The first one is, everyone should be able to choose their representatives. Second point, the parties and candidates should be free to contest election. Third one, election must be held regularly after a certain interval. Fourth one, the candidates preferred by the people should get elected. That means we give more importance to the people's preferences. They are selecting the candidate and we must declare them as the elected representatives. Election should be conducted in a free and fair manner. The corruption or using money or manual power in the election should be avoided. It should be conducted in a proper way. It should be conducted in a free and fair manner. So the question is, what make an election democratic? What make an election democratic? Rifa, can you read these points?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes.
Ma'am, from the beginning?
Yes, all the points.
First, everyone should be able to choose. This means that everyone should have one vote and every vote should have equal value.
Yes.
Second, there should be something to choose from. Parties and candidates should be free to contest elections and should offer some real choice to the voters.
Okay.
Third, the choice should be offered at regular intervals. Elections must be held regularly after every few years. Fourth, the candidate preferred by the people should get elected. Fifth, elections should be conducted in a free and fair manner where people can choose as they really wish.
Clear, children? Any point, any doubt? Same points are given in the textbook also. Same points is given in the textbook. But here in the PPT, it's a small points, textbook, a little bit elaborated. Only that's the difference. Clear? No response. Aditya, is it clear? Aditya? Aditya? What happened to the video, Aditya? Okay, John, Savio, Prajod, Rose. Melvin, now is it clear here?
Yes, ma'am. It is clear. I am listening.
Okay. So, okay, Nas. That make what make an election democratic? Then the next is, do you think that is election competition or political competition is good? Do you think that the political competition is good for a country?
No.
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 Yes. Why?
Yes. Yes. Somehow yes, somehow no. If it is good, why? If it is not good, why?
Ma'am, it has both good and bad side.
Ah, yes. Okay. So in the next class, you find an answer for this question, okay? Why is it good to have political competition? And why it is not good to have political competition?
Because
there's a small, not it's a debate. You can express your point, okay? Yes?
If there is no, this competition, if there is no competition, election will be pointless.
Ah, yes. That's why I told you. Then the next class you prefer. Okay, girls. Girls can prefer. Boys, which one you need? Is it good to have political competition? Are you supporting that political competition is good? Boys are not responding. Boys. You will find the points. Is the political competition is good. Girls, you can take that the political competition is not good for a country. Okay. Prepare some points and come to the next class. All of you prepare at least one point. Ready? No activities here. You are not only I am saying something and you are keeping quiet. That is not good for the class. Okay, are you ready, children? Yes or no?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
So prepare well for the class. Please don't say any excuse at that time, okay? Ma'am, I forgot, I didn't have it. No excuse. Only one point you must prepare it. Then if the too many points, we will get. No need for looking at the textbook. Textbook, maybe two or three points will be there. If you are checking or if you are thinking, we will get more than that points. Okay? For the next class, we can do like that. Ready?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes. So the next class, we can take that. You prepare and come. After your presentation, we can conclude that. So before leaving the class, we can take